Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing the first look of my Halloween 2017 videos, and this will be the melting jack-o'-lantern. So if you're interested in seeing how this is done, just keep watching.
So I'm starting off with one half of my face already done up with regular makeup because I figured I didn't need to show that part. And the other half, I partially blocked out my eyebrow. You can block it out entirely or not at all, it's up to you. I only partially blocked it out because I don't really care if it's completely flat. I just wanted to get the dark pigment kind of out of there for the most part. I only really care about making it super flat when I do looks like Spider-Man or Power Rangers, something that it's supposed to look like a mask and no, what's the word I'm looking for?
You kind of look like Napoleon.
Something
Dynamite.
Mask-like and no texture. I look like what? Napoleon Dynamite?
Yeah, with the blonde eyebrow.
With the blonde eyebrow. I look like Napoleon Dynamite.
Isn't he like albino?
No. But yeah, let's get started.
I'm gonna start out by taking a brown eye pencil and tracing out where the drips are going to be. I'm speeding this part up because this is how fast I'm actually going, and I didn't want this video to be super duper long, but just keep going until you get the shape that you like and you're satisfied with how the drips look. I made some thick and some thin. It all just depends on your preference. And then taking a black eyeliner pencil, I'm going to tight line my upper and lower lash line as well as lining the area directly outside of those water lines. I want this part to be as black as possible because we're gonna surround it with a bunch of black paint, so you want it all to blend in. Taking some black Snazaroo face paint, I'm gonna go ahead and paint in the classic jack-o'-lantern triangle eye, as well as the nose. And then I'm also gonna take that paint and start to line the drips. Taking some orange Snazaroo face paint, I'm gonna fill in the entire jack-o'-lantern sign. I used a smaller brush to get into those little parts that were right up close to the drips because I didn't want to ruin and get any orange paint on my regular side. And then this is where I went and filled in all the black parts. I filled it in with some black Snazaroo face paint and then topped that with some black eyeshadow by Morphe just to set that black powder, especially by my eyes, because when you open and close it, I didn't want it to crease, so I had to set it with a black powder. The other parts, I set it with a black powder to get rid of the shininess. There are so many different types of jack-o'-lantern faces. You literally can just make up your own as you go, or you can do what I did and just look at a cartoon picture of a jack-o'-lantern and just pick a shape. Now I'm taking some brown eyeshadow and tracing out those pumpkin lines, lumps, crevices, you know what I mean. I then went over that with some black face paint just to deepen it up. Taking some black face paint, I'm going to start shading underneath those drip lines. You basically just want to start from where your skin ends and then flick your brush down to create kind of that feathered, faded out look. Taking that dark brown eyeshadow again, I'm going to shade underneath all the curves of the drips. Anything that curves up or curves down, wherever it curves, I'm just going to shade it there. That's what help will make it look like it's popping off of your skin. I'm now going to take that black face paint and deepen up those lines just a little bit. And of course, when you add shadows, you should also add some highlight. So I'm just going to hit the curved part of the drips as well as the highest point of those curved lines on the top there and just hit it with some white. And then taking that black face paint, I'm gonna create some dots to make it look like little tears in my skin. Before I start the drips, I'm going to take some paper towels and lay it on my lap because this is going to get pretty messy. I'm going to take this Mehron 3D gel and just follow the directions on the bottle to heat it up. And then I'm just going to put this everywhere that I want the drips to be and along the line of my skin and the jack-o'-lantern face. You can add as little or as much drips as you want. I went a little crazy with it, but you don't have to do as much. There's really no wrong way to do this. But once this dries on your face, you don't have to worry about it sliding off. It stays pretty secure until you wash it off. And then once you're done with your drips and you got it to your liking, you are done. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Leave me any comments if you have any questions. And I think that's all. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so, so, so much. And I hope you enjoy my next upcoming Halloween makeup tutorials. Stay tuned for those. Again, I love you and thank you for watching. Until next time, bye-bye.
I don't really care when I'm... Like stuff where it just, it should, it...
If he was in the octagon, I'm Mayweather. He's Mayweather. The names are too close together. What? Chase goals, not people. Bye!
I'm so upset that I even heard that conversation.
Why? Huh?
Nothing. Just never mind. Forget it. Start your homework. I can't relate.
Losers. That's only the real can relate.
What the hell was that accent? Only the real can relate.
I put college ain't cheap, so the less money on gas, the better. Like, I pay for gas.
Like, you pay for college.
Hair's my own. I like the way you work it. I'm about to bag it up.